Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today I want to talk about the iShox base clamp for the smart remote for the GoPro. After a lot of searches online, I found the clamp hidden somewhere on some links. I have my GoPro mounted on the chin of my helmet with a GoPro media mod. So for me it's hard to press the buttons and not seeing if it works out. So that's why I wanted to have a remote. I know you can do it by voice commands, but as you can hear, English is not my native language. And when you are in a situation where you want to have the GoPro quickly turn on, I didn't want to have a battle with the pronunciation. So I'm gonna lose that anyways, and lost the shot, or lose the shot. So I was looking for a way to mount this smart remote to my BMW on an R1200 RT. The steering is not with round bars, so you need to have some special modifications for that. Those are also very expensive, and well, everybody has to work for their money, so I wanted to have a cheap option for that. I found some really nice clamps online, but they were also very expensive, and I need to have some other fittings as well to fix to my bike. And in some way I found the iShox. How do you call that? The iShox. I guess that's it. And it's I found them through some websites for 3D printing. And I don't have a 3D printer. A buddy of mine has a 3D printer, but he's very busy on printing all stuff all for Max Verstappen. So I don't think he has time for me soon. So I was looking for something that was already printed, and I found this GoPro remote base, and it's already printed. It's very sturdy. It's not not some it's not weak. It doesn't feel weak. Let me say it like that. It doesn't feel weak, and it also has the quick connection, just the quick mount option. And actually, you can just click it into the clip. Click it, and there you go. And I have from Amazon. I bought a set with 58 of those utilities. Some of these clamps. Those are very weak. Already, I broke one of these clips, but you have a lot of stickers with that, and those are really 3M stickers. So for about $25 I have 58 pieces, and I can work with that. So I'm gonna connect this to the bike. I will show that later in the video. I'll put it on the place where I have my radio. So as you can just undo this screw, you all know how that works, obviously. Connect it. And put that in the on the right way. Put it in there. And connect it this way, or the other way around, obviously, to my dashboard on the motor, or any place you want to place it on a bike where you don't have a default steer with round handlebars. So and easily disconnect it. I said easy, but it clicks so sharp and so loud that you feel that it will actually break, but it doesn't. It's very sturdy. So in the next section I'm going to show you where I'm going to mount this on my BMW, and there you go. So this is the place where I want to have the GoPro remote the smart remote installed on my bike. It is a nice place. It is tucked into in a sort of bending shape of the tank on the side panels. So I'm gonna do that. First I'm gonna clean that area a little bit so that the adhesive will work properly. There we go. And whoop. Then I'm going to remove the plastic. So there it comes off. Pressing it tightly. Actually, I need to have an hair dryer and make it a little bit warm so it flows. But yeah, well, there we go. This should be sufficient, and I can tighten the screw a little bit more, and there you go. When you press it hardly, it will go down. So this is when it's mounted. I can easily take it off, unscrew the quick mount, and there you go. And that's it. And even I can just flip the clip and remove it altogether. And I can then mount something else, like for an camera or whatever. So that's that. And just to see why it is not going to work on a steer, it's a completely different steer. So I can have pistons here, and then I can mount a ram mount on it or something. So, but then I have to buy larger bolts. I have to buy washers. I have to buy a sort of little pipe that goes in there. I don't know the exact word for that. Then a ram mount, and then I can fix this. And this is a much cheaper option. So there you have it, mounted on the BMW. I hope you liked this video. Please leave a thumbs up or a thumbs down if you didn't. Subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next one.